And now I'm starting your system. You can see it is accelerating. Today I am going to explain you the principle of the over-unity generator. The system is made of two motors connected together both mechanical way and electrical way. One motor works simply as a motor and the other one works as a generator. Because of the energy losses, this system would stop quickly, but I found the effective way to compensate them. The voltage rating of the generator has to be slightly higher than the one of the motor. My generator is rated 240 volts and my motor is rated 220 volts. This little overvoltage is enough to compensate the electrical and mechanical losses. You also have to compensate the induction nature of the motors using the parallel capacitor. Such a capacitor is nothing special. And now I am starting your system. You can see it is accelerating. And now at the full RPM. I just added a load to show the over-unity effect. I am measuring the output voltage. Now you probably ask why the output voltage is so close to the nominal line voltage. This is because of the self-stabilizing effect of those motors. The motors are designed so that their iron cores are just below the point of saturation at their nominal voltage. After the startup, the voltage is rising until reaching the point of saturation. Above the point of saturation, the efficiency of the motor is rapidly decreasing, so that the voltage cannot go higher in the self-running system. It would be no longer over unity. Please never try this at home. The system is generating very dangerous voltage. It can kill you.
When most people think about electricity, they think about these. But what if I told you you could get electricity from thin air? To get this free electricity, just take these few simple parts, and essentially, we're going to turn them into one of these. So I started with these parts, and this circuit plan, and made a solderless circuit like this. Here, I'll check the baseline voltage of the system before hooking it up to the antenna. Notice, there is no voltage reading. Next, hook up the antenna. The radio waves brought in on this antenna are the source of the free electricity. And now let's measure the voltage now that we have the antenna hooked up. Check that out. This is free electricity. I'll just hold this up so you can take a closer look at what we're getting here. So what can you do with this free electricity? Well, I've just hooked up this cable, so I can use it in an attempt to charge up my cell phone. Nothing yet. Oh, looks like I've got enough voltage. And there it goes. So here's your shopping list to make your free energy receiver. It's not really free because it costs $2. But if you don't have your own antenna, you can make your own with that simple antenna wire. And here's a simple circuit plan. Enjoy!